do is we're going to split up into groups. So I'm going to come around, I'm going to draw a piece of paper out. Oh, pick the good one.
Oh, one last one. Okay.
Oh, there it is.
Right there.
Yeah. Okay, up one, open them up. So each of you guys have a color on there, and y'all are gonna be in a group, but there's only gonna be two in a group. So here's the red group. If you have the red, you're gonna be red. The orange is in the back, and then the greens are up there. So go to your board, whatever color you have.
Green.
Okay, so this is your partner, so you might want to get friendly with them because we've been with them for about 6 minutes now. So, anyways, what I'm going to get you is a piece of paper, and it's going to have four things on it. And you're going to use these four things to invent something. You can create multiple things, anything you want. And I mean, okay, so like I'll give an example. So on one of these, it says a tractor. You don't have to use the tractor. You can use parts of the tractor. So it's up to your advantage, whatever you want to use. So I'm going to pass these out, and then I'm going to give you 3 minutes. But I'll tell you when I start the 3 minutes.
Do you write them on this thing?
Yes, you'll write them on your flip, on one of the sides, okay? Just one of the sides. Right. Okay. Okay, y'all get this one. Okay. On your mark, get set, go.
So we can make a bakery, right? Because we have a table with cake.
Huh?
Okay. Yeah.
What is that?
No, any like things, like or anything.
Can we make a place?
Place?
You can make a what?
Like a place. Like, we got cake. We got table. We got stuff. We can make like a bakery. Like,
yeah, like you can invent whatever you want to do. So. So your invention, whatever. You want a place, you want to make something new out of these things, you do it.
We're gonna, oh, shoot. So we have cake. We can make cake pops.
You know what, as much as you can. Whatever you want to use.
Cody's repurposing things.
Right? Okay, that's cool too. Anything? Wait, it's your invention. Don't forget that. Any you guys question?
Well, on one side, do we wrap
lion taming?
No, you use it all on the one side. You use one side for this.
Okay.
And we're going to use the other side for another thing.
Okay. So what are you going to write here?
Okay. So,
cake. Y'all got about less than 2 minutes left. Just kind of give it a range.
Okay,
awesome.
Did we get to explain it?
Yes.
Couches with
Do we write it?
Tables.
Yeah, no, that's going to be something else. So we're going to do that.
Or the tables that like pop out. That like they're like a coffee table, but then they extend and make more.
So I want to use that.
And a notebook.
Or a tractor seat. And I should make a sword.
Okay.
We can make snowflakes.
Like, that's really creative. I like that one for sure.
Okay.
Toga lime table. Okay. Ice cream resort fork? My bad. I think I like that. Okay, but this one's my favorite.
Give the ice cream cake.
Okay. Yeah.
Yes.
Take
it.
About 30 seconds left, so finish up whatever you're writing.
So you're doing a great job.
Wow, try that.
Is there an invention we can do?
We can do like weddings. Take wedding orders.
About 15 seconds left.
We have receptions at this restaurant.
They're going into detail over here.
Yes. We could have people could actually.
Okay, guys, put down your markers, please, if you don't mind too. Okay, so you guys had four items, and you could create anything with those. So you made your own new inventions of these four items. So. So we're going to start with the red group over here. So let's see the red group.
You go. Okay. All right. So we had a tractor, a shoe, some peanuts, and a blanket. So we took the seat off of the tractor, connected it to the blanket, put the shoe on the tractor seat, and filled it up with peanuts. So now you can jump off of a mountain and ride this parachute while you're eating some peanuts.
Nice job.
Let's out of the shoe.
Let's give them a hand for that. That's pretty creative, right? Okay, let's get back here to orange group. Let's see.
Can we use the cool one?
Yeah, use the
cool one. Alright, so we have a chair, a tablecloth, a milk can, and ice cream. So we made an ice cream resort fort with the chair and the tablecloth, and then you're sitting there eating ice cream.
Good job, guys. Let's get JC and Cody hand. Okay, let's get to the green group with Hunter and Katie over here.
So instead of just making like one thing, we made a place, a little hangout that you can have, and it's a hipster place that you can eat at. And so our items were cake, table, couch, and notebook. So we have cake pops, so you can make cake pops. We have those things, you know, the couches that have tables on them, especially like studying and stuff like that. With the notebook, you can make paper airplanes. You know, you can have a chill vibe. It's snowflakes hanging in the air. We could take cake orders with the notebook. We have a bakery. And then we can have like wedding receptions and stuff there, because everybody would be like, this is a cool place to have a wedding reception for like cake and the couch tables, and it would just be so amazing. So we have a cool, chill vibe place for people to chill at.
Good deal. Very creative. Yeah. I like it a lot. Let's give Katie and Hunter in the room. Okay, so you guys just made your own inventions with using these four items. So don't forget about those four items. Tuck them away, put them aside in your brain, but I don't want you to forget about them, okay? So now I'm going to ask each one of you to draw a piece of paper out of this bag. Okay, so either you have a person or you have something written on your eye, on your piece of paper. So I'm going to draw one out and give you an example. Okay, so I got the name, brand name too. John Deere. Okay? The person John Deere discovered something. So on your piece of paper, you're going to have a person or something that was discovered. So I'm going to give you 2 minutes. And the first minute, you and your partner are going to talk about what you think this person discovered or who discovered this item. The second minute is I'm going to allow you guys to get out your cell phones and use to research it so you can find it. Okay? And you're going to write this on the second piece of part of your paper. So this is for discovery. Who discovered something? Is there any questions? Or is there any things that are not clear? Okay, go. 2 minutes, don't forget.
I'm
going to
write this down. I have
Y'all got 1 minute to look them up. Some of you probably already know
So we wrote this on the seven.
Yes. Make sure you write whatever name or item you have on the second side of your piece of paper. Yes, Gracie, you do.
John Bone.
Okay, guys, you got 5 seconds left. When you get done, just go ahead and set down your pencils or markers.
Got it.
See if you of y'all still need a few more seconds, that's fine. When you get done, just kind of like turn towards the front so I know you guys are done. Would you have thought university?
We talked about it in my history class, but I just couldn't think of like.
Yeah,
it was, because there was like a bunch of them.
That's right. Y'all good, Horns Group?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, good deal. So let's go, starting with the green group. Now let's reverse it. So Katie and Hunter, and tell us what you got and who discovered or what they discovered.
Yes. So my topic for a place was University of Kentucky, and John Bowman actually discovered UK in 1865, and that was all part of the land grant initiative and all that fun stuff.
So, good to know you.
My word was roses. And the earliest rose flourished. I didn't know like anything about it because I'm not really like a plant kind of person, I guess. But the only word I knew or name I knew was Gregor Mendel, and I think I knew it because of the yellows and whatever. But apparently the earliest history of them was 35 million years ago, and they found them. They discovered them in like remains, I guess. Scientists and stuff found some in like ancient Egyptian tombs, and some of the earliest ones, like Cleopatra had them in her bedroom. So that tells y'all how much like it goes back. So.
Good deal. Let's give Katie and Hunter and some snacks. Collab or snacks? Okay, let's get a lunch group back here.
Okay, I had George Washington Carver, and he was a peanut breeder, and he discovered over 300 uses for peanuts.
Yeah.
All right, I had E.M. Tiffany. He was from Linden, Kansas, and he was the writer of the F.P.
Good deal. Let's give snaps to JC and Cody, and let's go to the red group up here.
Okay, so I had strawberries, and I didn't know much about like where they were founded or where they were originally grown, but they were first found in ancient Rome. I can't remember the year, but it was B.C. And then in America, they were discovered by Europeans in 1588. So, and it also said they are typically used for medicinal purposes, which I would have never thought of. I would just think to eat, but that was pretty cool.
Right. So I had Kentucky, so just the land area, said was first discovered officially by James Bride, and then was officially explored by Daniel Boone in 1769.
Good deal. Let's give Gracie and Vincent snacks. Okay, you guys can head back to your seats if you guys would like to. Invention versus discovery, right? So you guys invented something using 4 items, and then you find out who discovered an item or who discovered that. So let's just kind of have a little bit of a discussion. Can somebody give me a definition of what they think invention is? Go ahead.
I think it's just the creation of something. So maybe you have a spark of like imagination, and then you just take it and run with it. Or maybe like how we were given something and had to come up with an invention for it. So they can either come from yourself or come from like somebody encouraging you to like invent it.
Right. Anybody else? Your aunt, you look like you had, I don't know, but it's not like
I think it has a lot of creativity too, and like seeing the need and addressing it in your own creative way, like whatever
right.
it might be. So
right. Absolutely. Anybody else want to mention? Okay, let's hop over and look at discovery. So, what is discovery? Don't complicate it. Simple things.
When you find things.
Absolutely. Anybody else? Okay, let's look at what Google gives the definition between discovery and invention. Invention is the action of inventing something, typically a process or device. And discovery is the action or process of discovering or being discovered. So, even though like discovery and invention are like, wouldn't you say they're like a lot in comparison, they still kind of have their differences, right? So I guess the best way I think of it is like you discover something, but at the same time you invented it, like kind of that characterizes. So let's just talk about what is something that you think has been a great invention over the last 5 years. Cody, you probably have a good one because you farm a lot. Or you can use 10 or 20 years.
Embryo transfer.
Okay. JC's like, yes, yes, yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Right.
She's... You do goat, right?
Sheep and goat.
Sheep and goat, so for sure. Okay, anybody else want to think of an invention or discovery?
I think like an automatic cat feeder. I don't know how long ago that was, but that's like really evolving, especially for dairy research. Like they're like researching it and seeing if it's good for farmers, and I think it's going to be a good thing because I think bottle feeding, that's fun and stuff. It takes a lot of time for farmers, especially between milking and stuff.
Absolutely. I mean, just even think about before we had mechanical, like, to milk cows, like, everybody had to do it by hand. Like, that's, like, we've came a lot since that happened. What else could I do with you?
Gene editing. It's going to cure cancer in the world.
I hope so. I hope so, Cody. You're very right. So, even though we decided, like, what is invention and what is discovery, and even though they're alike, they still have their differences. So when thinking about these two things, who's the real competition when thinking about these two things? If you want to discover something, or if you want to invent something, what's going to be your competition? Yourself? What about the competitors?
I think there's still people out there that may be considered that competition, but all in all, it's like yourself because it's your own creativity.
Right.
And if each of us like fulfill our unique like purpose, we'll have our own invention and discovery.
Right.
So,
absolutely.
I don't know. Kind of bringing our own things to the table.
Yeah. So let's say Cody. Everybody knows Cody's from Flemingsburg in his little lovely hometown. And there's Hinton Mills in Flemingsburg, and it's been there for years and years. Family owned and operated. Everybody loves Hinton Mills. Well, Cody decides one day he wants to invent a new feed store in Flemingsburg. Burke Mills, okay? His competitor is going to be Hinton Mills. But Cody also has to discover something that Hinton Mills does not provide. They're a great company, but do like they cover everybody's needs all the time? No, absolutely not. That's not realistic. But what Cody needs to do is make sure he implements that in what he's inventing, right? Okay, so that's just kind of give you, allow your brain to go between the activities and learning about what invention and discovery is. So we're going to put those things, those two, invention and discovery, in our toolbox right now. But we're going to come back to those and how you can use invention and discovery in your TED Talks and RAs, okay? So we're going to switch votes here, and we're going to look at your RAs and your TED Talks that are going to be coming up. So we have two RAs that are going to be happening.
and we're going to have TED Talks that are going to be coming up soon, right? So what I need you guys to do in just a few minutes is I have put four posters around the room. So I'm going to walk beside each one of them and explain them. So I'm going to give you guys a couple minutes here in a minute. And I want you to think about when you've listened to somebody give a TED Talk. I don't know if you've like YouTube any TED Talks, or if you've heard somebody give an RA. I want you to think about what did that person do. So in somebody's RA, what was their delivery like? Okay, I will never forget Caleb Gustin's RA. He like got down on the floor and got really into it, and like I felt like I was there. Like that delivery was outstanding. So think about like what is their delivery like. And I want you to come up here and write that on here, but not yet. On this poster over here, I want you to name someone's speech you will never forget. So if you heard James Cash's speech this year, Wesley Estes, or somebody that we might not even know that you might have heard their RA. And it doesn't even have to be an FFA. Let's say you went to a HOSA state competition and you heard somebody's. Just somebody that has impacted you from a speech they have done before. On the third poster over here, how was that person's speech memorable? Like, what stuck with you? Was it the message they had behind it? Was their tone of voice? What was it that made it memorable to you? And then on our fourth poster over here, we have address. So, what was their address? Like, what were they trying to deliver to the audience? And don't get these mixed up. So I want you to think about, like, how did it impact the entire, like, if you were at, let's say, let me give you an example. So when my dad's preaching, how is he going to address everybody and not make sure he steps on any boundaries or make sure that it's what everybody needs to hear, okay? Does that kind of make sense? Is there any questions? Around the room, around here there's marker markers, so I'll just hand these out real quick for you guys. And just take your marker and just go to each poster and write down a few ideas, or if it's a word, sentence, whatever. Okay, go. I'm going to give about between 2 and 4 minutes to do this, depending upon how fast you guys get it done.
Yep.
you get done, you can feel free to take a seat, and then we will address the four posters when we get done.
Anybody else?
mine. So the lady that I picked, she actually did the TED Talk that I talked about in my journal. And we watched it in high school. And, like, that was immediately when Ms. Wright was like, pick a TED Talk. I was like, that one. Because it's, she talks about education, and that's kind of what, like, made me think, okay, maybe I can do that. So that's why it's memorable, because she's just so passionate about it. And she was like, you're going to run into teachers who suck. And she, like, literally said that. She goes, you're going to run into teachers who suck. And she said, there's one time that I had a teacher who said, I'm not paid to make the kids like me. But her whole point was, kids don't learn from people they don't like. And I was like, that's really true, but I had never thought about that.
Absolutely not. Anybody else? John Max, oh, go ahead, Ben.
Well, what I remember most about his is he talked about just how he had to learn to love himself and then to love people. He tried to commit suicide multiple times. But the thing I remember the most, he talked about his son and how he would never be able to hug his son. So he would have to love his son in a way that, as a two-year-old, he would have to learn, he would have to make the choice to hug him first. And that's just something that, you know, just learning how to love people in different ways.
Right.
Outside of limits that you have.
So Ben told me this person was at National Convention 3 years ago, would it be now? 3 years ago? And he was the keynote speaker. And I can tell you, if I was a high school student and I sat there and I listened to Nick give that speech, how impactful would that have been? Like, just kind of think, like, you never think about not having any arms or legs because we think, you know, we're just created with that. I mean, and never to hug your son, like, that's, like, super much. Like, I can even think about someday when I have a family, I have kids, like, if I can ever hold or hug my child, like, that's super deep. Let's transition, and I saw John Maxwell. I love John Maxwell. I think Gracie put him down.
I did.
Talk to me, Gracie.
Okay. He was at UK Lynn event last year, and something really cool was when he gave his speech, he sat down the whole time, and, like, that was something I'd never seen before. So it was very, like, conversational, and talked a lot about, you know, like, books he'd written and experiences, and I just remember also put down, like, action steps and applicable. I like that because a lot of times I can be very motivated, but if I don't have any way to put that into action, I lose it. Like, right once I leave or, like, a week later, I don't have any way to, like, take that and run with it. So that was something I really took from his speech was, and, like, for months after, I would remember quotes from it and use that in lots of different ways. So it was just really inspirational.
Absolutely. Anybody else want to talk about theirs? Absolutely. I'm kind of glad you guys have ventured out and y'all said some people that I didn't even think about and, like, told some things that I didn't even know about these people. But as we're going to make a full circle now from invention discovery to your RAs and TED Talks. So I'm not really sure if you're going to give your TED Talks to the class and you're going to give your RAs. Who will be giving RAs? You'll give those at convention. But I want you guys to think about, like, you can use those RAs, your TED Talks, for so much more than just the one thing that's for a grade or the one time you give it at state convention. So think about, like, I'm not really sure, Cody and Ben, like, you probably have a general idea of what your RAs are going to be. Katie, Gracie, JC, Henry, I'm not really sure what y'all's TED Talks are going to be quite yet. You probably do now. I don't necessarily know yet. But think about what are you going to discover in your TED Talk? When somebody listens to it, what are they going to discover about you? What are you going to invent inside of your TED Talk? I think those are, I necessarily never thought about inventing or discovering something inside of your TED Talk or your RA speech, necessarily because you think about the message. But think about those things. I don't know, it's just because me and James are so good friends, but I loved his RA speech. Like, I felt I lived through James's RA speech. Like, it was during my session, and I just felt like everything he said, like, I could relate to, even if I had never experienced it. And there were things that you discovered. Did everybody hear James Cash's RA? Discovered about James, like, how his parents had gotten divorced, and what he knew, the back side of his house had changed to something drastic, and that's not what he had thought about. But nobody would have ever known that about James, right? Probably a lot of people never knew that. But we discovered something about James. But he invented something inside of his speech that was much more than just that situation. He invented something that was called bloom where you're planted. Just because a situation happens or something happens in your life. In this class, we've talked about things that have molded you, shaped you. Things in our life that are probably sometimes stuff to talk about that was in that speech. So I kind of like, just remember the things, these people that you will never forget their RA because, like, it meant something to you. Like, I'm so glad, like, being talked about this person because now I, like, want to go home and, like, watch his RA, or not his RA, his keynote. So I just kind of want you guys to think about that. We're going to wrap up here right now. So just remember that you guys don't have a journal entry due unless you didn't do Journal 7. So that's due at the end of today. Spring break for next week, so y'all don't have anything yet. And then the next week we'll be back, and Miss Wright will be in here. So she'll be back teaching, and that'll be the week of that Journal 8 due. And then March 25th is our Saturday that we'll have the 5-hour class. Okay? Good deal, guys. Y'all are free to go. Thank you.